Dear students, today let's study the continuation of solving of equations. After this module, you will be able to apply simple equations to practical situations. We use equations to our practical situations. Okay, let's start our new topic, applications of simple equations to practical situations. In this, we have given some word problems. We set up equations, that we have to make the equations, then solve the equation. That is the method. Okay, let's see the first question. Set up equations and solve them to find the unknown numbers in the following cases. Here you have given some problems. Then an unknown number is there. We have to find that unknown number. Question A. When I subtracted 11 from twice a number, the result was 15. When I subtracted 11 from twice a number, twice means double of a number. We don't know the number, so we take the number as x. Let the number be x. Twice a number means 2x. Double 2x. So first we set up equation. Subtracted 11 from twice a number, that is 2x. Subtracted 11, 2x. First we take 2x. Subtracted 11 means minus 11, the result was 15, so equal to 15. This is the equation we made. From this, we have to find the value of x. Very easy. First, we transpose minus 11, it becomes plus 11. 2x equal to 15 plus 11. 2x equal to 26. Next, 2 into x, that is multiplied 2, it becomes divided by 2. So x equal to 26 by 2, x equal to 13. So which is the number? 13 is the number. Next question, B question. Munya subtracts thrice the number of notebooks he has from 50. He finds the result to be 8. First, we make an equation. Thrice the number means 3 times of the number. We don't know the number, so we take the number equal to y. Here, notebooks, number of notebooks. So, let the number of notebooks equal to y. Thrice the number means 3 times y. That is 3y. And Munna subtract this number from 50. From 50. So we write the equation as 50 minus 3y equal to 8. The result to be 8. Here is given result to be 8. So we write equal to 8. From this we have to find value of y very easily. First we transpose plus 50. The sign is plus here. So, minus 3y still there equal to 8 minus 50. We know 8 minus 50 equal to minus 42. Now, we divide by minus 3. Y equal to minus 42 by minus 3. Minus 42 by minus 3 equal to 14. When we divide 3 by 42, we will get 14. So, number of notebooks equal to 14. Then, C question. Ibn Hal thinks of a number. If she adds 19 to it and divides the sum by 5, she will get 8. Ibn Hal thinks of a number. We don't know the number, so we take the number as M, small letter M. Dear children, you can take any variable, but it should be in small letters. Let the numbers equal to M. Ibn Hal adds 19 to it 19 to it means m plus 19 and divides by 5. So divided by 5. M plus 19 divided by 5. She will get 8. So it is equal to 8. First we transpose by 5. It becomes into 5. M plus 19 equal to 8 into 5. M plus 19 equal to 40. Then M equal to 40 minus 19. M equal to 21. Therefore, the number equal to 21. So, Ibn Hal's number is 21. Next, D question. Anwar thinks of a number. We don't know the number. If he takes away 7 from 5 by 2 of the number, the result is 23. Here, listen, 5 by 2 of the number. We take the number as A, small letter A. Then, 5 by 2 of the number equal to 5 by 2 X. We take, remember here, this number is X, but we take it as A. So, we change this as X. Let the number equal to X. You change it as X. 5 by 2 of the number equal to 5 by 2 X. 5 by 2 X equal to 5 X by 2. In the last class, we discussed about this. 5 by 2 X becomes 5 X by 2. Now, we subtract. Takes away. Here you can see takes away. Takes away means minus subtraction. Takes away means subtraction. So 5x by 2 minus 7 equal to, result is 23. So equal to 23. So 5x by 2 equal to 23 plus 7. 23 plus 7. 23 plus 7 is 30. 5x by 2 equal to 30. Then 5x equal to 30 into 2, 5x equal to 60, x equal to 60 by 5, we will get 12 by 1, that is 12. So, number is 12. Next question. Raju's father's age is 5 years more than 3 times Raju's age. Find Raju's age if his father is 44 years old. We don't know Raju's age. We have to find Raju's age. So, we take it as Y years. Let Raju's age be Y years. 3 times Raju's age means 3 times Y. 3 times Y is 3Y. So, Raju's father's age is 5 years more than. More than means addition. Less than means subtraction. So, here more than. So, we make the equation 3 times Raju's age is 3y. 3y plus 5 years plus 5. Then, here father is 44 years. 44 years. So, we write here equal to 44. Now, we can find easy. 3y equal to 44 minus 5. 3y equal to 39. Y equal to 39 by 3. Transpose into 3. It becomes by 3. 39 by 3 equal to 13. So, what is Raju's age? 13 years. Next question, last question. The sum of 3 times a number and 11 is 32. Find the number. The number 3 times a number. 3 times a number. Number be x or any number. Let here the number be x. 3 times a number means 3x. Sum means addition. Sum means addition. So the equation becomes 3x plus 11 equal to 32. 3x equal to 32 minus 11. 3x equal to 21. X equal to 21 by 3. 21 by 3 is 7. So, the number equal to 7. Now we have a follow-up activity. Very, very simple question. Which is the greatest negative integer? Which is the greatest negative integer? Okay, children. That's all for today. Study well. Thank you.